Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And make sure you hit that like button. And we are going into these preseason tournaments. You see, we did lose last episode versus Kentucky. And we went actually on to win our next game versus Alabama A&M. And I want to talk about the release schedule for these videos a little bit. I kind of took a little break from just releasing these videos consistently, but they're going to start coming out pretty consistently along with NCAA football, so you don't want to miss any of this action coming up. So we do hop into the next tournament here with the Cyclone Challenge, but we do have some bad news going into this one. James Giordano with a broken hand, out 34 days after that first game. So we end up winning the first game versus UL Calcutta, and we actually blew them out by 30 points. We scored 75 in that one, 75-43. So we go on to play Winston-Salem State, and they are 1-0 after winning their first game versus Iowa State, which was a big victory for them. And now here we go. We are facing off in the championship of our second preseason tournament. As here we go, we are underway as we're on Iowa State's court here, and we do win the tip, getting it off to Falkering inside, but they do turn it over, and here is their point guard, Kim, pushing it up the floor, kicking it out, and that's going to be a missed shot. So both teams there cannot convert to start this game, but here is Sexton pushing it up the floor. He hits a deep three to start out this game, and that's a way to get started in this tournament championship. So here is back on the next possession, 4-3 here. Here's AJ Starr taking the deep three. They're coming up with the rebound, pushing it up court. Kim gets it up to Mutombo, who's going to take it all the way in. He's going to lay that one in, making it an early 6-3 lead. So here's Mutombo carrying the ball up the court once again, passing it off to Kim. Kim passes it to Traylor, and Traylor off of the glass. And we need to defend a little bit better here to start this game. But here's AJ Starr taking it to the lane, and look at this. Getting rejected already as Winston-Salem State has came out to play so far early on in this matchup. So here's Starr with the pump fake, driving it into the mid-range area and hitting the two. As like I said, I'd said in the preseason video that he's kind of a Carmelo Anthony type of build. He likes to take a lot of mid-rangers, and that time he converts. But here is Patterson to the free throw line. Here for his first attempt, missing that one, missing his second attempt, and that's going to be a theme early on in this game. Can we hit our free throws? As we're getting fouled quite a bit. Here is Harrison getting fouled on the three, missing that free throw. Here he is for his second free throw, missing that one, so he gets three, and he misses the first two, and he actually hits the third, so we're not hitting our free throws early. We should have this lead. So here in a 10-7 game, here's Mutombo getting it inside to Presley, and where is our defense on that one? That was actually Dorsey on the inside. So now 12-7, here is Traylor passing it inside, and there is another point in the paint as we give up another bucket. So now 14-7, here is Atkins driving the lane, and he's getting fouled, and he ends up converting on both of his free throws. So now here is Aziz on the outside driving inside. Here is Aziz laying it in, and he's got some driving ability. I do want to kind of unlock his potential a little bit because he has the potential to be a really good scorer. But here is Patterson on the perimeter getting ripped, and Mutombo's taking it to the lane untouched, and he's laying it up and in on the fast break layup, making it a 10-point lead already for Winston-Salem State. But here's Leonidas showing some post moves and laying it up and in, and he's got his first playing time of the season, and he gets his first 2 points as well. But here is our defense, been the Achilles heel of this game so far, as Winston-Salem State takes the 13-point lead and causes us to call that timeout. But more Winston-Salem State offense, as here is AJ Starr driving to the lane. He's getting blocked as they are just dominating so far in this first half. Here is Kim driving to the lane, getting his own rebound, laying it up and in, and that's an and one. So this lead is up to 15. We are not playing defense, not hitting our free throws, not playing offenses. Here is another steal from Winston-Salem State, and they're up 18 in the first half. As here's AJ Starr pushing the ball up the court, getting it to Juice Harrison. He can't hit the mid-ranger, but Falkering is there for the rebound, lays it up and in, and that's another 2 points, but only two, as we have not been able to convert. But here's Juice Harrison pushing it up the court, taking an open threes, hitting that one, trimming the lead to 16 in this first half. Here's AJ Starr driving it to the lane, can't get through, but here's Juice Harrison open again for the three. And maybe this is the formula, kick it out to Juice, as he's been hot so far with 2 3-pointers. But here's Falkering on the boards, but he can't lay this one up and in. We can't hit the easy ones, as here's Winston-Salem taking it in on the fast break, and they are just pushing the ball, crashing the boards, as they are dominating so far in this first half. But here is Winston-Salem, Kim at point guard, gets a pick from the big man, passing it inside to Higgins, and he lays it up and in for the and one. Our interior defense has just not been there in this first half, as they have just dominated us 48-28 going into halftime. They have a 20-point lead, as we have not been able to shoot the ball well. 29% shooting in the first half, and it shows on the scoreboard, 28-48, 4-12 from three, and our free throw percentage is not good at all. Juice Harrison has 10 points at the half, but mostly off of the threes he's made. AJ Starr has 7 as well. But on their side, everybody's doing everything. Look at the rebound totals. They have a lot of rebounds. We actually have a lot of rebounds too, but Falkering has the bulk of them, but their interior defense is just killing us, as this pretty much continues in the second half. As here is Kim starting it out with an easy fast break layup, laying it up and in, making it a 23-point lead. As here, 53-30 here, 14 minutes left in this second half. As look at this, another easy layup here for Winston-Salem, as Kim, the point guard, has actually 6 assists. As here he is passing it inside one more time to Mutombo. As wow, they are just killing us. A 27-point lead stretches to 29 points. As here's Lionel Shorts getting in the game, driving to the lane. He lays it up. But man, this is a 27-point lead here in the second half. But here, playing some defense, here's Lionel Shorts providing a little bit of a spark off the bench as he gets the steal and lays it up and in. And we make it a 25-point lead. But Winston-Salem just continues to pour it on. Here's Mutombo driving it to the lane and laying it up and in. And we just have no answer for this offense. Look at this. All these easy buckets. Another one inside, as that has just been the story of this second half. Here's AJ Starr with the open three. He hits it, but still a 22-point lead here in the second half. Is here another possession. Braden Sexton at point guard, but getting ripped. And look at Higgins passing it up to Latham. And Latham's going to lay it up and in. And wow, this is just a sad, sad game here in the second half. As Higgins with another open three, he hits it. And they've been killing us inside. And that pretty much puts the nail in the coffin as they go on to win this one. 89-63. They shoot 53% from the floor. We shoot 34%. As that's the huge difference. We actually shot the three well. We shot 35%. It's not horrible. They shot 33%, but we missed 8 free throws. That was big in the first half. It kind of gave Winston-Salem State the momentum. But we actually had 20 turnovers in this game. I mean, just sloppy offense. They had the interior defense on lock. Kim goes for 10 assists for them, and Mutombo shoots 10 for 21 from the field. Looking at our team, like I said, the only bad thing with AJ Starr is that he's going to take a lot of shots. And some games he's going to have a great game, but this game he went 4 for 17, and that's not an efficient game at all. So we had to work on our interior offense and defense. So we work on the rebounding with Leonidas going into this game. I plan on giving him some more playing time as we head into the 5th game of the season, going up against Yale. We are 2-2, they are 0-1, and they have a couple of guys, no real superstars here, but we do have to take care of business in this rivalry matchup. Our first game at home, we have to show out for the home crowd. So here we go. Here's the tip here versus Yale, as we do not play them in conference play anymore. We move to the ACC. But here we are on defense, starting out this game with a steal. Here's Falkering driving to the lane. He's getting fouled, as that's a good way to start this game out, with a steal and a foul in transition. So here is Frederick for Yale taking the three, and he's hitting that one as he was wide open. I don't know who was covering him on that. So here's Braden Sexton from the point guard position, passing it inside to Falkering, and Falkering is laying it up and in, making it early 4-7 game. So here is Atchison passing out to Frederick for another three, and he hits that one and he's got six early on. So here is Frederick at the top of the key this time, passing it to Atchison this time, and Atchison's taking the three. So they come out to a 13-4 lead early on in this game. So here is Falkery taking it to the rim. Nobody's there to stop the ball as he's got the only 6 points so far. So here is Starr on the steal in transition, picking up an easy layup. He lays it up and in for his first 2 points. I want to get him some more efficient shots. So here is Patterson with the defense. He's taking it to the lane and dunking for the first poster of the year. Patterson is a really good player. He plays good defense. He's a veteran on this team. And man, what was that guy thinking going up for that block? As now we are down by six early on in this first half. But here is Braden Sexton passing it to Lee Lee into Falkering. And Falkering's going to lay it in for 8 points early on in this game. So here is Harvard back out on defense. And we put in Johnny Lovingood. Johnny Lovingood is our defensive point guard. So he's got to set the tone on defense here, making a move to the lane and getting fouled and lays it up. And he ends up hitting one of two free throws. So now in an 18-13 game, here's Lovingood in once again. And he's providing that spark as he gets fouled going to the lane again. But here he is on defense this time with the steal, driving it all the way to the lane. And he ends up passing it out this time in an 18-15 game, getting it into Lee. And you see the defensive spark. We are coming back in this game. So now down three. Here's Lovingood at point guard, driving it to the lane, laying it up and in. But there's Leonidas on the cleanup duty, as that's what he's been in the gym working on, making it a one-point game. So here's Aziz on the missed three, but Lionel Shorts gets the rebound, lays it up and in, and that's a lead for Harvard, our first lead of the game. So now back out on the full court pressure. Here is Atchison driving in, but look at this defense, and look at Lovingood providing that spark and setting the tone at defense. And we are playing some pretty good defense so far as since he's come in. But here's AJ Starr with the open three, and he hits that one as it's now a 24-20 lead here on the miss once again. Here's Leonidas on the board, passing it up to AJ Starr. He's going to take it to the lane and lay it up and in. He's got 7 points so far in this first half as it's now 26-20. But here's Lovingood playing some defense, and Lionel Shorts is there, and he takes it in for the dunk and making it an 8-point lead as this first half does wind down. But here on the miss three by Patterson, here passing it back out to Patterson is AJ Starr. But AJ Starr's open in the corner for the three. And this has been a great comeback so far in this first half. But one more time, another steal, AJ Starr from the three-point line, he hits it. As that's gonna propel us to a 34-23 lead going into halftime. As wow, what a way we ended that one. AJ Starr hits three threes to end the half as he has 13 on pretty efficient shooting. He had a really nice looks on that. And we start out the second half. But here is Jameel Aziz to start out the second half. And he gets going with the bucket that time. And let's just take a look at Jameel Aziz, because he starts getting hot. As here he is with another shot. He hits that one for a three. Here he is driving to the lane, lays it up and in off the backboard. He's got seven. So here is Lovingood here with a 13-point lead, driving to the lane. There is Aziz once again, and he hits a three as he's got 10. He is heating up, much like AJ Starr in the first half. Here is Falkering getting double team, passing it out to Aziz, and he hits another as that one's actually a two. But still, getting hot so far in this second half. But here he is. Can we make it another one? Yes, we can. You know, he reminds me of Kevin Garnett. Just his release in his shot, it just looks a lot like Kevin Garnett. And if he can develop that three-point shot, he's going to be a really good player as AJ Starr is on the board. And one more time for the boys back home. There's Aziz. He hits another three in the corner. And now we have made it a 23-point lead here in the second half as we are continuing to run with Lovingood at point guard. Another layup that time by Leonidas that time, as here is Lionel Shorts getting open for the three. As man, we are just opening up the floodgates here in the second half. Here is Patterson open for a three, and Lovingood with an assist. And man, the spark that he's provided off the bench has just been unmatched, as here he is with the steal this time off the deflection from Patterson. He lays it up, but he cannot hit that one. That's actually pretty funny. a 30-point lead here in the game late in the second half, as here is Patterson. Another open three that makes it 10 threes in the game. By far the most we've had in a game so far. Here's Colley off the bench. He's getting in garbage time. I want to get him some playing time, get him some experience as he hits the three. But here is Dorsey after the steal, passing it up to Colley. He's laying it up and in, and that's going to be the story of this game. Our defense in the second half just dominated as we put up 91 in this game. And wow, we just blow out our former rival in Yale as Jameel Aziz just gets hot in the second half. He goes 7 for 12 from the field, 3 of 5 from 3, and a rebound. But AJ Starr carried us towards the end of the first half. He had 16 points total. Jameel Aziz, they both had 17 and 16 respectively. This is just a very, very efficient game from our bench. Leonidas had 10 rebounds off the bench. Loving good definitely provided the spark on defense. But look at the steals. He had 3 steals. Patterson had 5 steals. And this was just night and day from that game versus Winston-Salem State, as we actually cut down on the turnovers. Only 5 total turnovers and 20 steals. That's the type of game you love to see. And we actually shot the ball a whole lot better versus Yale. And this was our first home game, so we were looking to kind of give the home crowd a show. We shot 45% from the field, 35% from three, and we missed only 5 free throws, hitting 75%. So this was actually night and day from our first game versus Winston-Salem State. 5 turnovers to 22. We first forced 22 turnovers. If we can play this type of defense, we're going to be hard to beat. So, man, stay tuned for this, man. We're going to start putting these videos out in bunches, so you don't want to miss any action. Hit subscribe. Hit that like button. Harvard, here we go. We're 3-2 on the season to start it out. So stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.